little powder time. Tuck tape. So this is our blue glow. That's, why is that hard for me to say?
Wow.
Question is, did I mix up enough? I was debating my volume before.
Hey guys, if you haven't subscribed yet, hit subscribe and then hit the bell too to get notified when we put out a new video.
Hope everyone's staying safe. It's quarantine still a little bit, but we're opening back up and we figured, I don't know, let's do something fun. Let's do something we haven't done. We're going a little stir crazy here ourselves. So instead of the massive setup we normally do with a front-facing camera and maybe an overhead camera and then pickups on the side, I'm just gonna do a project and take you guys along for the ride. So we know these connected smart light bulbs, right? Well, we have the thought, what if instead of using, you know, an actual outlet, what if these could just glow on their own? So that's where this is gonna come in handy. That's our glow powder. Yes, this is glow in the dark powder that you're gonna add to your resin, and it'll soak up all the UV rays from the sunlight and then glow in the dark. Okay, first things first with this, we're gonna actually make a mold of this. Now, I could do a crazy mold box and build this up and clay this up and try to do a two-part mold of this. I don't really feel like doing that. And also, I would assume that you don't feel like doing that either. So I'm gonna show you something. We're gonna try something out. And it's a trick I've done a few times, but it's actually just picking the right container, putting it in the bottom of the container, and then just going for it. So look at all these containers here. I'll explain what I'm talking about a little bit more. So we've got these plastic cups, paper cups. You've got these graduated cups here. Some of these have been used. I still like to keep them because they're still kind of a value. We have big ones and medium ones and kind of smaller ones. What we're actually gonna do is clay up just the base of our light bulb, and then we're gonna just put it in this cup and just pour silicone right over it. And it makes it a lot easier. You don't have to build walls and worry about leaks and worry about, I don't know, a bunch of other things that can go wrong and that have gone wrong many times for me. Very frustrating. So, yeah, that's not gonna work. 100%. Well, paper cup was a good thought. It's not gonna do the trick though. Oh, I like that. That's more promising. I am gonna add a base of clay to the bottom of this though, just a little bit. Kind of, I'll probably make it. So, that's not a lot. That means we're not gonna have like a much silicone there with this mold. So I don't like that either. I don't think that's the way to go. Well, we know this is gonna work for sure. No question, it fits in there, no problem. Here's the downside to this, is if we do this, if we go this route, that's a lot more silicone. It's gonna be around the walls of this. And I don't like that. I don't wanna waste silicone. The smaller, the better. That's why I like this idea a little bit more. See, this is what we do here. A lot of this gets cut out normally. See, the funny thing is you're probably already thinking of something that's smarter than what I'm doing right now. You have the benefit of the future, okay? Give me a little bit of a break here. Here's what I'm gonna do. So this height is really good. There's plenty of buffer, but there's like a little too much buffer, I would say. So I think what I'm gonna do instead is I'm actually gonna cut this cup. Yep, that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna cut this cup. I may be sending us down a terrible path. My only promise to you is that we're going down this terrible path together. Let's see. So I'm gonna count for just a little bit of the base of this. So I'm gonna say just a little bit of clay comes up. Not much. Then I want a little buffer. But you really don't want, I don't want that much. I'm actually only gonna cut off like what looks like a little bit. Now here's the thing, watch your fingies. I'm just kind of gently scoring this because I don't wanna go to the hospital. That doesn't sound nice to me. We're learning today, folks. We're learning today. That's the most important thing right now. That and water, because dehydration's a real possibility right now. There we go. That's a little bit better. I like that a lot more. If that's gonna sit in there like this, I can, okay, watch this. Be cool, watch your fingers. Safety, safety, safety. Cut this down the middle. And then I can actually, and this is gonna be hard to tell, but I can actually, hey, now I'm happy. Look at that. Even though that doesn't seem like a lot, that's probably the difference between one size of kit and another size of kit of silicone. So now what I have to do is figure out where I'm gonna combine these two sides together to make my new smaller cup. For that, I'm gonna use tuck tape. Maybe you've seen this before, maybe you haven't. It's one of my new favorite things, actually. I really like this tape a lot. This is, this is Canadian Technical Tape Limited. That's who makes this. It's for, why can't I think of the phrase? It's for like HVAC, other things like that. Very strong, but it's also waterproof. That's one of the big sides. I'm gonna kinda eyeball this. And I'm not trying to leave a ton of space. I need a little bit, but I don't need a massive amount of buffer, maybe a quarter inch at most. That's probably gonna be okay, right around there. So I'm just gonna grab my marker. Something I learned the hard way with tuck tape is you absolutely need to do that old trick of folding over back onto. Yep, to get that so it's easier pull. Otherwise you will be very upset with yourself as you sit there trying to get it off the edge. So I'm just gonna line up my line. Try to get the stickiest tape in the world here. And I'm just gonna leave a little bit on the top, that's no big deal. And I'm gonna push down with my thumb, I'm just going right on that seam, because that's the most important, is that seam. Sweet. Okay, here we go. Real quick fit check. Perfect. Okay. You know, I could put a piece of tuck tape on the inside too, just for double protection. I'm gonna do that. It's gonna be a little bit harder. We'll figure it out. Almost didn't fold. Almost didn't fold over. Woo! I'd have been mad at myself later for that. There it is. Call me exact, but the less flashing, the better. Okay, so definitely feeling confident no silicone's gonna come out the side. The bottom is the next question. I am gonna do a little bit of just a tiny tuck tape fold over there. Okay, there we go. So there I've just taped it on the inside again real quick. Now I'm intentionally doing this because there's this little, see that little tiny gap there? No silicone's gonna come in from this way or from that way, but it could end up kind of maybe coming underneath the bottom here and getting in between there, and that would just be a mess. I don't want to deal with that. So, super fast fold over. And now we're good to go. Oh, you know what I did? Oh, I didn't do the fold over. Luckily, I'm done with it. That's the time for Jordan to get frustrated at himself later. I think some corrugated plastic that we have is gonna work perfectly. I've got a scrap bin as well. This will work for things that I've done other projects on. We don't need a lot. In fact, I'll use this guy. I like the width. It'll be easy for you all to see. It's one of my favorite things about this plastic. It's these flutes. Looks like cardboard a little bit. So it's actually really easy to cut. So something like that. Just put my blade in the middle of one of those flutes. And then right down, good to go. I'm actually gonna use some Sculpey, or you know what, I'm gonna use our synthetic modeling clay instead. I'm gonna create that little tiny stand now, stick our light bulb in it, then we'll go over top with this hot glue, maybe a little bit of clay for my own emotional sake, and then we'll go from there. So let me go get that synthetic clay. Okay. So this is our synthetic clay. I'm not going to open up this package, though, because we have plenty of leftovers. Because synthetic clay doesn't dry out, so you can keep using it. That's one of my favorite things about it. So that's what we're going to do. Grab a stool, because otherwise I'm going to end up with back problems at 40. I don't want to deal with that. And, okay. I will show you this, because I care about you and I don't want you to go through the same things. This clay will come off on your fingers a little bit. We'll add some blue. So you don't need to worry about like necessarily, oh, it's getting on my skin and I'm so nervous. It's not that. We're just gonna put a glove on so that it's not as messy. So I don't have to keep going and washing my hands again and again and again. So that's why we're gloving up. I'm gonna grab one real quick. It'll make this process a little easier. All right, gloves on, sweats on, way too much hair is on. Excited for those barber shops to open back up. Just need a little bit. Let's see here. I'll start with that. I think that's about right. I'm gonna have a little bit more here though. So I'm just gonna kind of warm it up a little bit. It's a little cold. Haven't used clay in a hot minute. Haven't done a two-piece mold in a while. I'm gonna go about middle. Yeah, it's about right. I'm just gonna kind of wiggle my way down a little bit here. So I'm gonna shape this a little bit more even without the light bulb in there. And that's mostly because once I push this light bulb in, I'm not gonna be able to do as much shaping as I want to. So it's better just to do that now. All right, I'm feeling pretty good about that. I like that. In fact, you know what? It's almost the size. You know what? It's almost the size of my cup. I think we should just do it. I'm gonna kind of make a little bit more of the spaghetti noodle that we all made in elementary school. Maybe I just made. It can't be just me. And then I'm just gonna go around just like that. Just do it real quick. Oh yeah. This was the right call, folks. Feeling confident now. So I am gonna smooth this out just a little bit. When you're using synthetic clay like this, the nice part is we're actually gonna take up even a little bit more surface area, so we're not using as much silicone still. Should have left it alone. Should have left it alone. I am gonna shoot you straight. This is the second time we've done this. We'll just say the camera died and we're gonna move on. We're not gonna bring it up again. Okay. So here's what we got. We've got our mound here, the first one we've done, wink, wink. And we've got this little ridge here. I made that ridge because we're gonna press down on and it's gonna give us a tight seal. I'm just pushing straight down, but it's way more natural to actually screw this in. So we're gonna do that. We're just gonna screw this in. Okay, there it is. I'll do just a tiny bit of pressing, just a little bit. Not much. That's not what we're doing. We're not trying to change the world. Now it's a little off, that's okay. Push it a little bit back. Goodish, we're good. This is quick and dirty. I'm not trying to do the greatest thing you've ever seen in the world here. We're just trying to get this done. My light bulb's in there. The clay's gonna keep that locked to the bottom too, so we don't have to worry about that, which is great. We don't have to hot glue it or anything. I'm gonna push this into this cup into the clay, so that's gonna give us an airtight seal too, and I'll do a little bit of extra afterwards. And we're cooking with gas. Moment of truth, let's do it. All right, I am where I need to be. 3, 2, 1. Oh, that's fantastic. Got to check in here. Did I get, okay. I kind of sliced this one a little bit. So there's a little bit of hangover. Honestly, that's okay. It's not going to affect things too much. It just means there's going to be some silicone that gets in there. It's not going to affect the mold itself. So I'm not mad about it. It's not worth crying over. Now, this extra clay here, what we could do, we could just like rip this off if we wanted to, but I'm going to use it. Let's double down. You know, the last thing I want is a leak on this. So I'm just going to use that gloved hand still, and I'm just going to kind of, and this is great. Hot glue, not needed. Don't need it. All right. Silicone. Little alcohol spritz, a cloth. Kind of gets rid of a lot of it, at least some of it. Save you from just ripping through gloves and gloves and gloves, so it's a little bit easier that way. Okay, let's talk silicone, shall we? I'm gonna keep it simple. I mean like simple. So I'm going old school amazing mold rubber. This right here, you can actually pick this up at Hobby Lobby, Michaels. You can go get this. You don't even have to order this online if you don't want. This is gonna work perfectly. Now the question comes down to how much we need. We would definitely need at least 2 kits if I hadn't cut the cup. Now's the question, will we need 2 kits still? I was okay at math in high school. I wasn't like phenomenal at it. So we're gonna do some rough estimating and use the volume calculator. Touch ID, don't look at my password. Goodness. Gah. F-A-L-L. I'm teasing, that's not my pa-. You thought it was fall. That's just because I'm really hot right now and I was missing the seasons. Got it. And I've got a cylindrical volume of about 48, a part volume that I'm estimating is about 12. So it gives you a net volume of 35 cubic inches. That's how much silicone we need to take up. What does that mean? It means we need maybe a pound-ish or so, 746 grams, about that's gonna do it. All right, so here's the deal. We're gonna go for it. All of it. We're just gonna do it. Why hold back? Here we go, there's your base of the silicone that we're using the amazing mold rubber. So those two guys, we're gonna combine those and we're gonna use all of it. And we're gonna see how close that gets us. Glasses on, because now we're mixing some silicone here. Put your safety glasses on, be smart. Gotta shake this up a little bit before you mix it in there. So we're gonna use all of this. Feeling, team. I can feel it. It's like a storm's brewing. Okay, that's good enough. There should also be, that's correct, another little foil cap here. Quick cut off of that. 10 parts of this to one part, 10 parts of the base to one part of the catalyst. But if you're like me and you're using it all, no measuring involved. Just dump the whole thing in there. So I'm gonna stir this together. I am gonna kind of take my time at first though, because that catalyst just kind of sits on the top. So I'll just kind of poke down the sides a little bit, kind of get underneath of itself a little bit, do a gentle folding here. Nice thing about amazing mold rubber, open time is 20 to 30 minutes, so you have a good amount of work time. And the demold time is about 2 to 4 hours. So one day you could do this project, no problem. Now, if you are using our epoxy with this amazing mold rubber, you do want to let this cure for the full 7 days before you start your casting. That's an important thing. Also, I can't communicate to you enough how much, I don't know what this muscle is. You know, the pressure point thing when you were kids is on fire right now because of this straight stirring what feels like maple syrup with a tiny, just squeezing just the most baby, it's just a baby stir stick. And I'm hot. I'm like a fussy child right now, aren't I? This is about I'm pretty sure it's 38 on the shore scale. So it's kind of a middle of the road silicone rubber. It's not the most flexible, let's say like our Plat 10, or the most intense like our Plat 55. All right, straight hand cramp. I've been stirring for about 2 minutes so far. I'm gonna do another at least minute and a half, at least up to 3, maybe 4 minutes here. There's not a lot to mix, so it's easier. All right, sticks over there. This comes into play. Here's the thing when you're pouring silicone. You don't wanna pour directly on the part. You wanna try to pour on the lowest part. Can you see the fog right here? Oh yeah, I'm a little foggy, it's hot. You wanna pour on the lowest possible spot and not directly on the part. That's gonna be a little difficult here. So if we get some on the light bulb, it's totally fine. But I'm gonna try to pour kinda down the side here and we'll go from there. Fingers crossed, guys, no going back. Oh man. Oh. I don't think so. I think we're mixing up. I think we're going for two. It honestly doesn't get much closer than this to be. So I'm not gonna mix up another complete batch, but I am gonna mix up some more because I want that light bulb completely covered for this mold to be usable. So we're gonna fast forward now, save you the time. Ready, set. There we go, we're back. That was a marathon. That was not a marathon, that was a sprint. That was fast. And then I'm just gonna pour right on top. Wheat. Perfect. Now's the waiting game. And now's when Jordan goes into the office where the AC is, lays down on the ground, and tries to recoup for a little bit. I'm out of coffee. Not a good way to start day two. That's all right. Oh, yeah. I could act like that was what I wanted, but that was the grit at the bottom, which is no bueno. Here we are. Done, sealed. Yeah, this is good to go. There's nothing better than opening the door of wherever you are, your workshop, your room, pick the space, and not seeing a leak anywhere. That feeling is just fantastic. So what do we do now? We are going to, I'm gonna re-glove up, same reason as before with this clay. I just don't want it to get messy. I don't wanna have to deal with all that. So we're gonna remove this clay, put it back into that bucket over there where I keep all the extra. It's also not as hot in here today, which, well, huge relief. And if you, yeah, that's what I was looking for. If you can get it, and if you do it right, it should actually come off pretty cleanly. It's pretty great. So I'm gonna pull this. I'm gonna remove that. And there is our base of clay, which is sweet. So we're actually gonna demold this, I promise. I'm not just gonna leave you hanging. I'm gonna cut down the sides a little bit. That does leave a seam line. I'm not worried about that with this project, but it also leaves potential for leaking. We don't want that. So we're gonna actually reuse this kind of plastic housing, and we're actually gonna use it as kind of like a, think about it like rubber bands, but it's gonna be a consistent pressure. So when we actually do our casting, I'm gonna reuse this, use some more tuck tape, and we'll do that. So that's why I'm not just gonna rip this apart and destroy it. I am, though, gonna continue to remove this clay. And look at that. Boom. Perfect. There's a little bit of like flashing and all that. Again, not worried about it. This right here is the base. So when we fill up our resin, this resin will actually come up to the top of this like a little volcano. And that will allow this glow-in-the-dark casting to actually stand on its own. Pretty perfect. Next up, I'm gonna just go ahead and just take our X-Acto. Look at that. And that's our inside seam on the tuck tape. See, now you see why I wanted to show you guys this, because it is so much easier than building a building a melamine box or dealing with the corrugated in a certain way. If you've got a project and it works to use something like this, can recommend. This we'll put to the side, give it a little, some of the extra clay. That's a save for later thing. Okay. A little X-Acto knife action, or you can, if you want to, just rip. You're not gonna ruin anything, but you might as well try to get a somewhat clean line here. All right, so getting this light bulb out. Couple ways to approach this. You could just go to town here, but then you risk ripping this silicone. I mean, this is a strong silicone. I'm not super worried about that, but I'd rather be smart about it. I mentioned, you know, cutting down the sides, so that's what we're gonna do. Because keep in mind, if you could imagine, inside, this light bulb actually, the majority of its mass is at the bottom. And this is the only hole I have in the mold. I can't get this massive light bulb through that. So that's why I'm gonna have to cut down the side a little bit. We'll work it out. But in the meantime, we'll pull apart a little bit here. Oh yeah, releases like a gem. Here's the thing with a seam line. If you just kind of go for it and cut really jagged, you're gonna end up with a seam line on your cast part that's gonna be really jagged. So you wanna take your time and go straight. And then straight out. Now you'll see some people actually will, once they get further out, they start to do this so that the actual silicone maybe locks together. I'm not worried about that, like I said, because we're gonna be using that plastic as kind of our gate. So I'm gonna stop right about there. You can already see a lot more of the light bulb showing through. 360 spin, like it's Tony Hawk, and keep going. So I've stopped about even here, and you can see what we're working with. So now the opening here, because I've actually cut down the side of this mold, a lot easier. I could keep cutting, but at some point, I don't want a two-piece mold, right? I want this to be one piece. So what you can do is you can kind of stop, try to get it out, but I can already tell you, I need to cut more. Where the plastic meets. So there we go. Look at that, much better. And then it's just a good grip. If you're having trouble getting this stuff out, a little trick that I use, if I've got a good grip on something, I'll actually go in a little bit circular of a motion, and that kind of dislodges things a little bit easier. So close, so close. There it is, done and done. Now you see why we use the plastic bulb. A glass bulb, that'd be dangerous. Ready to be cast. I got a little bit of clay on here. I should have taken my gloves off realistically, but that's okay. A little alcohol will clean that right up. It's a fun noise. Let's clean this mold up, and then we should use some glow powder. A little bit of isopropyl, 91%, spritz, spritz. And then we'll just kind of wipe this off a little bit. Get some of that out of there. If I use too much alcohol in this mold, it'll actually affect the resin. You can end up with like a lot in the bottom. You can end up, if you just spray it in there, it'd sit down there and it would kind of pool up and you wouldn't get a good casting. So that's why I spray it on the cloth, then use the cloth. I am debating what I'm gonna use. So the size of this object, I could use some of our Alumilite Clear, Clear Slow, one of our casting resins. That's perfect for this. I do want a clear resin though, because I'm using the glow powder. So, but I don't wanna use Alumilite Clear. I wanna use maybe something that you guys have more frequently used, which is our epoxy. That's our amazing clear cast. And since, yeah, that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna use our amazing clear cast. So, I know, I recognize I have access to a lot of epoxy. Okay, so why amazing clear cast for this? Well, the clarity you get from clear and clear slow is, it's phenomenal. But this glow powder kind of makes your end casting a little bit hazy anyways. Imagine any glow-in-the-dark object you had as a kid. That's what this is gonna look like, which is great. So we don't need that insane, bubble-free clarity here. We can tolerate a few bubbles. So this is a much more cost-effective product than one of those urethanes. So I want to show you how to do a cost-effective solution here instead of asking you to go get a pressure pot, you know, do a bunch of extra steps here. This is quick and dirty. This is quick and simple. Epoxy's going to be fine. Safety first. Glasses and gloves. I've got my glasses here. Stir stick. Mixing container. I'm just adding things as we go. And then I'm actually going to use a scoop as well. This scoop right here, if you remember, we used Amazing Mold Rubber. This scoop comes in that kit, so we're just going to use that for the glow powder since I didn't use it for the mold rubber, which is perfect. I did mention that we were keeping this, right? That we were reusing this. Here's why. I don't want epoxy spilling out over there. So if I wrap this and get it done right, that gives me dimensional stability, which sounds really fancy. It's not that fancy, guys. It just means nothing's going anywhere so that I can cast without any spills. Simple, straightforward. And we are gonna lock that in real quick before we start mixing and pouring. It's a tricky process. Take your time, get it right. There we go. Much better, much, much better. So I'm gonna let that go. And then, oh, I told you I was gonna pay the price earlier. Here I am paying it. And I gloved up too, which makes this almost impossible. Shortcut. Okay, no, we're good. We're good, we're good, we're good, we're good. Everybody relax. Wow. All right, make sure everything's nice and aligned. And then right on the seam. Bada bing, bada boom. All right. Mold is ready to go. I'm not going to use any mold release of silicone. It won't need it. If you want to, you are more than welcome to. That'll extend the life of your mold a little bit. Stoner, UMR, great choices. Let's just diagnose what just happened there. That tuck tape, I thought had enough centralized mass, even though it was a baby piece, so I just threw it with utter confidence, and where did that go but just right here. So, okay. There's the proper. There we go. Now we're cooking with gas. Epoxy time, everyone's favorite time. Glasses and gloves, be safe, be smart. And I'm just gonna use our 16 ounce kit. That's 8 ounces of A, 8 ounces of B. So, I always pour B first, because B is a little bit thinner than side A. That's our resin side, hardener side. So putting B first in there means that A is not sticking to the walls from jump. So that's what I do. Do whatever you want though. This is your gig. Follow your heart and your dreams. I'm just trying to figure out how much I want to use. I don't want to waste too much. We're going for 12. Yeah, we'll do 12. You could fill this up with water to a certain size and then actually put your light bulb in it, and then you can see where the water line goes up, and the difference between those two will tell you exactly the volume. Another thing that people do as well is they'll put rice in their molds before they actually start pouring, and then they'll take that rice that's in their mold, pour it into a mixing container like this, and see how high up it goes. So you can get exact. I'm just gonna rely on a little bit of experience and intuition. I'm gonna do 8. I can always mix up more. So I'm gonna do 4 ounces and 4 ounces. And then 4 ounces of side A. Now, I mentioned this in our mixing video, which you haven't seen that mixing video, you should go watch that before you just start jumping in here. Give you a nice how-to a little bit, but one of the things is shadows on cups like this. Since they're frosted, they can play with your eyes. So I actually always look in to the inside of the cup when I'm doing my measuring. It's a little pro tip. Oh yeah, I think that's almost gonna be exact. Or a little short. I can always mix up a little bit more. So I'm just scraping the side, rolling the cup in my hand. I was cooking dinner last night. I was browning some meat for tacos and grabbed an oven mitt, picked up the pan, and started scraping the sides subconsciously. Could be a high point or a low point, depending on how you look at it. Considering the temperature in the shop, which isn't as bad as it was yesterday, I think about 4 or 5 minutes is gonna be definitely enough. I'm gauging that based off of, are there swirls? Is it completely clear? What's the viscosity like? It wasn't like ha-ha funny joke. That's my job. All right, I'm feeling groovy. Feeling super groovy. Glow powder time. So this is our blue glow. That's, why is that hard for me to say? This is our blue glow powder. And now this, the gravity of this is a little heavier, so don't be shocked when it just kind of goes right to the bottom like that. We'll mix it in, we'll get it suspended, it'll be good. Oh yeah, now I am gonna go ahead and whip a little bit more here. I can afford to, because I didn't add a lot of air before, because I wanna make sure I get all this combined really well. And you can see why I'm not super concerned with air, because it's a little foggy, right? It's not our normal crystal clear. So we can tolerate that. Ladies and gentlemen, it's go time. Okay, here we go. Question is, did I mix up enough? I was debating my volume before. Now I'm really debating it. I think I did. Okay. Yes, we did. Perfect. Okay, so I could stop there, but I don't want to. I want this thing to be able to stand up on its own. That's why I've got this ridge that we built with that clay. So I'm going to keep going and fill that up. We're done. We're done with today. Now this has to set up. We'll come back tomorrow, demold this, juice it up outside with some UV lights, and then we'll have some fun. All right, ready, set, switch. Here we go. Am I out of coffee too? I think I'm out of coffee. That's all right. It's all come down to this, folks. It's been maybe 5, 10, 15, 20 minutes for you. It's been 3 days for me. Look at this. We're good to go. This is what I call the dry test. That's how you know your epoxy's done. All right, here we go. Let's just jump right in. So I'm gonna go ahead and cut down this side here. Sweet. I got a little bit extra on this lip, that's okay. There was actually, if you can see, there was actually a low point in the kind of ring that I had used. So that's where extra from the top kind of came and spilled down though. So that's actually, that's not a leak, which is something I'm very thankful for. That's why, children, you take your time and you make sure your seams aren't a little bit off. If they're a little bit off, it's not gonna go the way you want it to. Now I feel like we should have a discussion. In my hurry to get this video done for you guys, I used Amazing Mold Rubber because it's a great starting mold rubber. A big fan of it personally.
It's fantastic. The key, though, is with our amazing clear cast, you need to make sure that this mold rubber has the full cure of 7 days. Otherwise, your epoxy may end up tacky where it's actually touching the mold. The inside will be cured, good to go, but the actual outside could be tacky. So I'm potentially about to unearth a huge mistake for you guys. It feels really good. I feel fantastic doing this on camera as the pseudo expert who you're supposed to know and trust, but we all make mistakes. Me too. So let's just jump in and we'll discover together. So I'm just gonna pull these edges away. Okay, it's a little tacky, but I think we're gonna be all right. Oh yeah, there we go. Now remember, we didn't degas, we didn't do anything. This was just quick, simple. This is how you get it done. If you wanted to have no bubbles on the surface or on the edges, all you have to do is do a little degassing first or actually pressure cast this. But I know not all of you are gonna have that. I wanna show you how to use this glow powder. That's what we're doing here. Okay, you ready? It's a fun noise. Glad we use plastic. There you go. Glow in the dark light bulb. Regular light bulb. This was a fun one. And we're gonna do more with glow powder like this, and I don't know. Do you guys have any other fun ideas? I'm down to try whatever. So maybe throw a comment in there, like and subscribe, because, until next time, folks, go make something.